we got the biggest shareholder giving and taking up their full rights.
Ladies and gentlemen, KenGen is returning to the market today to raise an additional 28.8 billion through a rights issue for investment in various energy generation projects. I commend the KenGen Board of Directors and Management for seeking market solutions for its funding needs. The government, through KenGen, is committed to expanding power generation capacity to meet the needs of our economy and transform Kenya into an industrial economy by 2030. For this reason, and in order to support KenGen's energy generation growth, the government will take up its rights value at about 20.2 billion. The timing of the offer couldn't be better, coming as it does on the heels of the company's good financial performance, where its half-year total revenue increased by 52% to 18.2 billion in December 2015, up from 12.1 billion in December 2014. This good performance should reaffirm the investors' confidence as they review the investment opportunity. You will recall that in the past decade, the country has grappled with the challenge of unreliable, expensive, and unsustainable energy, leading to a stagnating industrial and manufacturing base. This has been due to aging energy infrastructure. To address these challenges, the government has formulated strategies whose objectives are to rapidly expand power generation capacity, enhance and upgrade the transmission and distribution network, and develop renewable and green sources of energy like geothermal, solar, wind, biomass, and small hydropower.
KenGen has a history and record of delivering mega projects efficiently and on time and also at cost. We have a large asset base, which is the solid, gives us a solid growth platform. We're an emerging world geothermal leader. You saw that Kenya is now number 8, with another country there with probably 20, 30 megawatts above us. And with the projects that we've shown down there, you can see that we're going to overtake a number of those countries. We have a strong growth and profitability as shown in our results that we released last year, and also our half-year results as of December 2015. And we have also maintained a consistent and stable dividend to our shareholders. And the fact that we are also market leaders, we currently command 70% market share, and we intend to continue being the leaders in this sector in terms of providing power to this nation, even though we appreciate that others will come in because we cannot raise all the capital resources required to meet the demand for the nation. Now going forward, we have a growth strategy, and as I've already indicated, geothermal is our main focus. Between now and 2020, we expect to add onto the grid approximately 720 megawatts, and out of that, it's only about 90 megawatts that will be wind, and the balance of others will come from geothermal. And you can see the projects that we've targeted at Hood Hotline, and we've also indicated the same in the information memoranda that you'll be receiving.